warm welcome to each one of you again. I think it's a privilege to be here. I'm just sharing with some of the people that how I've seen Pune grow, way back in 2004-2005, when Maharashtra city was just a plan. And today, not just Maharashtra city, but the whole environment has changed in Pune. And I think there is all the big, Fortune 500 companies are all in India. Some of the very large Indian corporations are, Pune that way was very well known for large corporations, even in those days when I was growing up. So I think it's a warm welcome to each one of you. My intent is to just set few minutes of the conversation and then, get ahead with Sanjay and Rakesh. I really wanted to share four key points in today's evening. You know, the world has changed substantially and is continuing to change very rapidly. I think this is something which, we were even talking, the VUCA world has become an old world now. So it's no longer just VUCA. I think somebody has to find a new one to talk about what's happening to the world. Having said that, I think if I have to look at the world from a business perspective, I think two things are clearly happening. One is the vision of business models for corporations is changing. You can see that's one of the core elements of all organizations today, the business models, the way they will do their business, the way they will run their business engine or the commercial engine is completely changed. That I think the visualization has started happening brilliantly, number one. Number two, the visualization for technology is also very, very rapidly gone, actually to the extent that it's gone miles ahead. And the business is still catching up with the technology. So I think that's a big challenge there in the business environment. So visualization of business models, visualization of, the technology is happening. But one area where I feel, and this is something which we have started focusing on as part of the Shared Services Forum, is the visualization on the world of services is still not emerged as much as we should have. At the end of the day, the customer experience or consumer experience is on the service. It is not just about the business models. It's not just about technology. So one of the, I know there's, one of the big conversations we will have today is about services. But our passion is to make sure that the world starts looking at it differently and we, in our own way, what we call as Global India, contribute to that visualization of services and Shared Services Forum will make sure that we see that very differently for the next, at least I would say minimum 5 to 10 years, number one. That's the first one. Visualization of services has to take its own place to make a difference. Second one, I think this is something I was talking to a couple of leaders about a year back, but I think it's very relevant even today because this was a conversation with one of the large technology organizations. And the point we were talking about is, I strongly believe the business process is a function of two things. I do believe, when we talk about outsourcing of services, manufacturing world is the mother of the services industry. The way they have transformed services, robotics, I have seen when I was pretty young, And I have seen deliberations of robotics will substitute people, and this could have a problem, people will no longer have jobs and all those stuff. And today we are going to get into the same conversation with, technology world. Secondly, information technology is the father of all business process services or business services and whatever you call it as. So one of the things I wanted to notice to him is that China, in the global environment, took a huge leap in the world of manufacturing. Huge leap. And we were left behind in manufacturing. Maybe to some extent today, India is making the difference. But having said that, I do, when some of the large organizations in India started acquiring companies overseas in the manufacturing environment, that's also very true. But having said that, we are way behind in manufacturing from a global competitive advantage. But I think we have an opportune moment today for India. India, global India is a crossroads. This is a moment for us to grab the global stage for services. I know we have become a global hub for services, but that's just still in India. I think we have to actually make a global presence. How many innovations will happen on services from India is what is important. How will we be cost effective in services? That's what is India is supposed to talk about. So in my mind, if China-led manufacturing, services, India has a huge opportunity, and you know, various leaders sitting in this audience will be able to contribute. That's the second point. Building on this, I just want to give the third point, which is today the industry where we all are working together has got 4 million people deployed. And if I take the indirect people, it's about another 10 million. So totally 14 million are deployed in this industry. And we, of course, contribute a substantial portion of the GDP. That's one part of the story. But to demonstrate the point number two, imagine our you know, employable resource are running into hundreds of millions. And if we can only make this 14 million to 40 million to 140 million, I think we have a huge opportunity to make a difference. So it's important for us to take that leap going forward. And I think every one of us sitting here could make a contribution. So given these three key points, that we have to visualize services, and that is behind. Technology is taking a leap, business models are taking a leap, but services is not. And that's what the customer is talking about. Second, China for manufacturing, India for services. If we can make that difference, then India will become global stage. Number three, this 14 million direct, indirect put together has to become 140 million. In my mind, education is important. People have to understand what services is important. I was just talking to Rahul that the way we will look at education in this space is, has to be completely different. I think if we don't do that, we will lag behind. So that's number three. Last but not the least, therefore, if I come back to the theme of the event today, obviously we have to break the boundaries. And if we just continue to live within the boundaries, we were deliberating about beyond boundaries, breaking the boundaries. But I think beyond was looking like still the boundary will exist. But breaking the boundaries would mean that you have to change the way the people will do business, right? So breaking boundaries is what we're talking about today. And the world of services is happening today in Pune, in Novotel. And you are witnessing to that wonderful event today evening. So have a great evening and thank you very much.